In this video, we will see when the bars are arranged in series or parallel combination, what type of stresses are developed inside these bars. The bar in series combination are also called as a compound bars, or the bar also another way, the bar in a composite section or bar arranged in a parallel section are also called as a composite bars. First see the compound bar. Or bar in a series. Let us say we are having a two bars like this. We are having two bar like this, which is fixed at both ends. Let us call this is A point, this is D, C point, and this is B point. And we have given an increase in temperature. We are heating this bar, and a change in temperature of this bar. We have changed the temperature of this bar by T degree centigrade. Now, as I said earlier, to imagine any thermal stress problem, first of all, remove one of the support. If we remove the support B, support at point B, what will be happen inside the bar? We will see that one. And to find out the thermal stresses, we have to introduce bar. We have to introduce the support in the bar. Again, I am repeating, to imagine the thermal strain in the problem, we have to remove one of the support, and to calculate the thermal stresses, we have to introduce the one support once again. Now let us say we have removed the support at point B and we have allowed the bar to expand. Now the temperature is increased by T degree centigrade. This C point will come here. This is the original length. This is original length. The C point will come here. And CB is originally like this. And after deformation, the C point will come here. B point will come here. CB is originally this length. After deformation or after thermal expansion, the B point will come over here. This is original length. That is a CB. Now we can write like this, or we can say that the bar, this is AC bar as a 1, we can denote AC bar as a 1, and we will denote CB bar as a 2. In equation they will say the bar 1 will have is having linear thermal coefficient of expansion as a alpha 1. We know the bar, we are increasing the temperature of the bar by T degree centigrade, and let us say this is L1, that is initial length, and this is L2. This bar 2 will have a thermal coefficient of expansion as a 2 and length 2. So this nothing but that is a, this change in length is nothing but alpha 1 T L1. This change is nothing but alpha 2 T L2. Now as I said earlier, there is a support on this bar. There is a support at B point. So here action is on this side. Action is on this side. So reaction will be developed on inward side. Action is on this side. Reaction is a opposite side. So this is RB and this is RA. Remember one thing, the value of RB and RA are magnitude wise same, but direction wise opposite. The values of RA and RB are magnitude wise same, but reaction wise opposite. So in the question, if it says find the reaction ratio of their reaction, we can write like this: RB, RA by RB is equal to minus 1. Why minus 1? Because they are direction wise opposite and magnitude wise same. The magnitude is 1. Here 1 will come because RA and RB is having same magnitude, and here minus sign will come because they are having a opposite direction. So we can write like this, this is R. So we can write like this, RA is equal to R because they are having same magnitude, and RB is equal to R. So reaction at this point will be coming as a R. So this reaction is a compressive reaction, and this compressive force will bring this point B to their original position. This is the original position of B. This is original position of B. This compressive load will compress this entire bar up to their original position. So we can write like this. This compressive load. So we can write like this. The load, entire load in this entire CB section is minus R. The load in entirely on AC section is minus R. So we can write like this, total change in length of this bar AB bar, that is total change in length of this AB bar before deformation. We know that before deformation and after deformation, the length between A and B is the same. So total change of length of this total bar is a zero, as it is fixed at both ends. So we can write like this, alpha TL 1 plus alpha 2 TL 2, alpha 1 TL 1 plus alpha 2 T L 2, and this, due to this compressive load, there is a compressive strains developed, and the compressive deformation we can write like this, minus plus or minus R L 1 by A 1 E 1 minus R L 2 by A 2 E 2. Always remember that when we are increasing the temperature, there are two types of deformation. First deformation is a thermal deformation, and second deformation is a axial deformation due to the reaction developed due to the supports. So we can write like this, R by A1 is a stress in a bar 1 and R by A2 as a stress in bar 2, and we will take these two terms on left side. We will get sigma 1 or forget about this, we will write it again. We can write like this term, R L1 by A1 E1 plus R L2 by A2 E2 is equal to alpha T L1 plus alpha 2 T L2. From here we can write like this, from this equation we can write like this, sum of axial deformation is equal to sum of thermal expansion. From this equation we can write like this, sum of axial deformation, this is axial deformation and this is thermal deformation, sum of axial deformation is equal to sum of thermal expansion. But we know that R by A1 is equal to sigma 1, R by A2 is equal to sigma 2. So we can write like this, sigma 1 L1 by E1 plus sigma 2 L2 by E2 is equal to alpha 1 T L1 plus alpha 2 T L2. We can write like this, and let us say this is equation number 1. So as I said earlier, to solve any strength of material problem, convert the problem into two equation and one known, and this is first equation. Now we are interested to find out the second equation. Let us say, as I said earlier, the load in this member is minus R. Let us call this is load in this member as a CB, or let us call loading this is minus R as a load in the member AC. So we know that load in the member CB is equal to load in the member AC, that is the value is minus R. So we can write like this, load in this member CB, we know that load is equal to, or stress is equal to P by A. Stress is nothing but load by area. So we can write like this, load is equal to stress into A. So here bar AC is nothing but bar 1. So we can write like this, equal to sigma 1 A1. This we can write like this, sigma 2 A2. So this is equation number 2. In a question, they will you the coefficient of thermal expansion of both the bars, initial length of these both the bars, and they will say the temperature of the bar is increased by T degree centigrade, and they will say find the stresses developed inside the bar. So in this question, we are having two unknowns, that is sigma 1 is unknown sigma 2 is and so on, and they will give the value of L1, L2. Young's modulus of velocity, they will give the value of alpha 1, alpha 2. All these values are known to us. In this question, we are having a two unknowns, that is sigma 1 and sigma 2. Here, A1 and A2 are known to us, and sigma 1 is unknown, sigma 2 is also unknown. So, we are having a two equations and two unknown. We can solve any type of problem by using this formula. Remember this thing, that is the sum of axial deformation is equal to sum of thermal expansion or thermal deformation. If you know this formula, you can solve a lot of conventional exam question.